In a world with VRChat's SDK installed, we can come down to VRChat examples, Udon program sources, and we can see a bunch of example Udon scripts provided by the VRChat devs for us to learn from. Today, we'll be looking at the script buttonSyncAnyone. Now, this script is a modified version of the base script buttonSyncOwner, and thus this video is a continuation of my video covering it. I would recommend watching that one first. So now, how is the script different? Well, if we were to playtest this, just like before, when we hit the button, it counts up. However, unlike before, when a second player hits the button, it also counts up, bar a slight delay. So, coming back into Unity, if we open up the graph, we are greeted with a script similar to the one that we had before. There really is only one thing that has changed on this whole script. Before, when we played the event on click, it checked to see whether or not we are the local player, as it is doing here. However, unlike before, if we are not the local player, it makes us play this Udon behavior send custom networked event node. This node is set to tell the owner to play this custom event. The reason being, if we can't change the value of the synced variable, we can just tell the owner of the object to change it instead. Now, this isn't the only way to allow a second player to also hit the button, but it sure is pretty easy. It also doesn't involve changing ownership, which makes it more reliable if you don't want to risk losing button clicks when multiple people are spamming the button, causing multiple transfers to happen. Then again, that doesn't usually matter. Well, that's all there is to the script. As usual, feel free to leave a like on the video if you liked it, leave a comment down below if you have any questions, and feel free to check out some of my other tutorials that I have on the channel. But until next time, bye bye.